sweet spot on this thing.
Hey golf people, we just made it out to Carrollwood Country Club and check this out. I've got a bag full of wedges. That can only mean one thing, we're testing out new wedges. But what wedges are we testing out? It might blow your mind, it blew mine. We're looking at the Costco Kirkland Signature Wedge Set. This comes in a 52, a 56, and a 60. We're gonna go out to the fairways and hit some full shots, see how these things fly, how they stick and stop on the greens. We're gonna do some chipping, and then we're gonna take them out to the bunkers and see how we get out of trouble with them as well. If you're ready, I'm ready, let's put them to the test. All right, we're standing out here about 85 yards. We're gonna go 53 degree wedge here. So I've got my Cleveland 53. We'll start with this one, then we'll move over to the Kirkland. Three balls each. A little right. Good action on it though. That's a good shot there. Look at that check up, nice. Just try to hit it a little further this time. I don't think it quite got there. All right, but it's a nice spin there. All right, that's three there. Now we've got the 52 degree Kirkland Signature, so it should go a little further. I'm gonna use the same type of swing and we'll just see what happens, okay? Ooh, it felt good. Try that. Nice action there. Really smooth. Really liking what I'm getting seen out of that. Really liking that. A little lower trajectory there. See how it spins. Pretty good, guys. Those were better shots for sure. It felt good. These feel a little bit light, but I'll tell you what, the ball just seems to fly off of them. We'll have to check the spin there, but if you're up in the higher handicaps, this is a really easy wedge to hit. Maybe on par with that Mizuno I tried a while back. I'll leave a link to that video here, but really, really good. Impressive, impressive, impressive. All right, let's go to the next test. I'm gonna use my rangefinder here. We'll get a 60-yard shot. We're gonna use the 60 degree wedge. I will battle this against my Cleveland, which is at 60, and we'll use the Kirkland Signature 60 and see which one gets them tighter. Let's do it. We've got the Kirkland Signature 60 up right now. Just a little harder. All right, I left a few out to the right there, but all in all, really good. All right, the Cleveland's up to bat here. Now, this is an older club, but it's still an incredible club. One of the best wedges ever made. Ooh, I flew that very long. I hit the wrong wedge. A lower trajectory and long. Not a great strike, really. Again, a little lower. Better there. It's a good shot there. That's another good one there. Oh, that went in! That went in! Oh man, you gotta be kidding me! Maybe I shouldn't switch. That's a little left. All right, well, let's go check these out. Once I got the Cleveland under control, I hit a few good shots, including dunking one in there. So, all in all though, I'm really happy with what the Kirkland just did. They're all pretty good shots. Took me a couple shots there just to get used to the 60 degree. Once I did, everything looked pretty good there. Let's take a look at these, all right? All right, so here's my first couple of shots. Everything with a black dot on it is the Kirkland wedges, okay? Just a little short of the green there. I was just getting my bearings. Here's a pretty good shot here. Looked like it spun a little bit. We'll have to check the tape. Back here, we've got a couple balls. I did hit 12 balls, guys, so that was a lot of balls there. All right, that's a Kirkland. That's about a 10-footer. A little bit longer here. There's another Kirkland signature. Now this is going to be a couple that I've airmailed with the Cleveland. A couple more in the green here. Again, this is really good. That's the Kirkland signature. Sometimes it's just getting the right distance, the right weighting. Here's one I pulled a little bit. This one's a little bit pulled here. Still not a bad, still not terrible. We got about 15 to 18 feet there. Here's a really good one. This is another Cleveland. This is the one I hit right, I think right before I hit one in. And there we go. We've got a ball in the hole there, guys. Try to get this out without damaging the cup. Woo, that was pretty nice. It's nice to do every once in a while. That's a lot of balls in my pocket, guys. Bulging. Are those your golf balls, or are you just happy to see me? All right, well, really liked what the Kirkland did, especially as I got my bearings with the club. That was my first few shots on course. I feel like I dialed it in there and I hit some really good shots. Hit a couple better shots with the Cleveland, but such is life, okay? I'm not a robot. But I really liked how they performed right there. I'd say, with the exception of the one that went in, which in some ways was kind of lucky, they performed pretty on par. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's a dozen balls in the pocket. All right, guys, I'm gonna test both of these out right now. So we've got them both 56 degree wedges. This is my SM5 Titleist Vokey. It's a few years old by now. They're up to SM8 by now, but it's very comparable, I think. But we're gonna go right up head to head. We can see this one has a little bit more bounce to it, just a little bit more bounce. The top edge is about the same. I do like the milling here is very similar as well. First up's the Vokey. Nice trajectory there. Check. Didn't check up quite as much as I'd like. More here. Right at it. Ooh, that's almost in. All right, now I'm switching over to the Kirkland. In hand, it's a little bit lighter. Face is a little bit bigger. More power there. I'm gonna get used to this one. You definitely seem to have a little bit more pop. I don't have to swing through it as much. Might be because the shaft's a little bit lighter. Nice. All right, so first impressions here. The Kirkland signature feels a little bit lighter in hand and the face looks just a little bit bigger. I don't know if you can see that, but the face looks just a little bit bigger than my Vokey. You can see there's a little bit of grass on there now. The Kirkland signature seems to have a little bit more pop as well. I didn't have to swing quite as hard to get the same amount of distance. Might have to do with the weight. And I'm gonna try one more here using a slightly tighter lie. First, we'll go with the Vokey.
Ooh, that's in.
Ha! I'll take that.
In the hole.
Checked up pretty good there. Not as good as the SM8.
Could be in too.
That was pretty good, guys. We had one in, one hit the hole, and the other one was pretty good as well. Checked up really nicely. All right, now we're gonna go with the Kirkland here. Really nice, checked up nice. Oh, that hits the hole. Just hit it a little too hard. One more here. Get in the hole. All right, Roel, the results are really comparable. I did hole one with the Vokey, but I also hit the hole with the Kirkland just a little bit too hard. All in all, I like the way this thing checked up. Now, it does take some time for me to get used to because this is a lighter head, no doubt about it. All right, so I feel like I have to have a little bit more control with my hands and arms than I do. That's a little bit more pendulum-like with the Vokey, again, just because the weight is more down towards the bottom of this wedge. But in terms of performance, once you get used to a wedge like this, I think it could perform from these two situations just as good as any wedge. All right, now I'm pulling out the 60 degree wedge here, and this is gonna be a little trickier shot because we have a lot less green to work with. This is where I really wanna test, does that weight prevent me from really being able to control the club and control my distance on a short little pitch shot here. For this one, I've got a Cleveland. This is my Tour Action 900 that I played with for a lot of years, and I still chip around the backyard with this one a lot. So I have really good familiarity with this club. We'll test it right up against the Kirkland Signature and see what does better.
Ooh, bad. Ooh, take that.
A little chunky there. Okay. Just a little tentative. All right, we're moving on to the Kirkland Signature here. It feels a little bit heavier, maybe. That took a bad hop off the fringe, but that was a really good shot. Bam! That's in. I like how this club is getting up in the air a little bit easier through the grass here. You can see it's just lofted just a little bit more. Whoa! All right, now we hold one with the Kirkland Signature there. I really like how this moves through the grass. I feel like I'm able to get it up in the air really quickly and really nicely. Let's try a flop shot, a little bit different shot here. I'm gonna move back just a little bit. We're gonna see if we can have a nice flop up in the air.
Chopped nicely. Wasn't anywhere near the hole though. There we go. A little better there. Not great. Okay, let's switch over to the Kirkland here. Get a little better. Oh my goodness.
First swing that just went in. I gotta say, it gets up in the air a lot easier than my Tour Action 900. All right, last test here. We're gonna take these sand wedges here into the sand. See how this thing gets out of the bunker. We've got the Vokey SM5 straight up against the 56 degree Kirkland Signature. Let's see what happens.
To be fair, I'm going to do Kirkland Signature first here.
Ooh, a little long.
Okay. Get out of there. Not bad. We'll go one more here. Seems to get out of the sand very easy. I'm not having any problems at all. Let me see if I can fly one and stop it. I'm gonna fly it a little bit further and stop it. Or not. Okay, so far so good. Now we're moving on to the Vokey here. Whoop, airmail. Airmailed. Took a bad hop there off the apron. Ah, short. Took a little bit behind it there. Take one more. There we go.
All right, so onto the sand here. I gotta say, I'm pleasantly surprised once again with the Kirkland. I'd say it's just as good. If you look at the dispersion over here, it's just as good as the Titleist. I'm a fan, guys. I'm a big fan here. All right, it's final conclusion time here with the Kirkland Signature. I've got to say, this is an absolute slam dunk home run. Bottom of the ninth, grand slam. The Kirkland Signature wedge set is legit for $53 a club. I don't see how you can beat it. Only gripe I would say is I'd like a little bit more spin out of the bunkers, but apart from that, everything else was absolutely wonderful, including those 53 degree shots and that 60 degree flop shot I hold. I'm a believer, guys. And the other benefit to buying these at Costco is the fact that you can return these hassle-free, 100% money back guarantee. So if I was you and I had a Costco card, just go out and buy these things. Play with them a couple rounds, see if you like them. If you don't, return them, no harm, no foul. I'm keeping these actually, and I've got plenty of wedges I like. These are staying with me. I'll catch you back here, guys, very soon on another edition of Let's Play Through.